Soccer Laduma Radio.
Hello and welcome to Soccer Laduma Radio. I am your host, Nkululeko Nkeu, and this is a special edition of the big interview. Well, I'm about to hand over the reins to a relatively new guy in the industry. He's going to be our new host at Soccer Laduma Radio. His name is Oluetu. You will hear a lot from him over the next few days. In this episode of the big interview, he speaks to a high-flying coach, Steve Barker, who's number two in the National First Division, is playing tomorrow against the other high-flying team, TS Galaxy, to reclaim his top spot in the National First Division. So they'll talk about that and generally the mood in the camp at Stellenbosch FC. So enjoy this conversation.
Soccer Laduma Radio.
Good morning, Mzansi. XA Day is getting closer. Caller, what's your XA shout out?
My XA shout out goes to all my girls from Emakaya, Emakasi, and to the city.
Ooh.
It's time, girls.
Naganjani, next caller.
It's time to vote, South Africa. 8 May 2019 is XA Day. Voting stations open from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. To vote, bring your smart ID, green barcoded ID, or valid temporary ID, and make sure that the IC has your address. Go and make your XA heard by voting on the 8th of May 2019. Dial 0800 11 8000 or visit elections.org.za. Your X is your say.
Stellenbosch, they have a game in hand, which they are playing tomorrow at 3 p.m. And on the line right now, we've got their coach. Coach, a very good morning in Cape Town today after a blessed Easter weekend. Jesus Christ being crucified on the cross on a Friday night and then waking up 3 days later. I'm not reading a script for you, coach, but for your team, your said day was versus Utongati 9 days ago. And the fans of Stellenbosch and the people of Cape Town are hoping your team resurrects tomorrow against the high-flying TS Galaxy. How are you, coach, and how ready are the boys?
Yeah, no, good morning. 9 days ago, we had a poor sort of a result. You know, it put us in a difficult position, but it is what it is. That is football. You're not guaranteed to win every single match. So we now need to, tomorrow becomes a very important game for us, obviously against a team that must be spirits are high after making the Nedbank final. So, but yeah, we're ready for it. We're up for the challenge. If ever we have to show our character as a team and as individuals, it is tomorrow.
Yeah, wow. Coach, you are coming up against a team that you drew with 1-1 in the previous fixture that you played in Makopane early this season, a mid-table team in the National First Division that is also in the final of the Nedbank Cup, but with an inconsistent record in league games. There are 5 previous games. They have 2 losses, they have 2 wins and 1 draw. But without looking away at the Stellies' 5 previous game, coach, this looks like one of those fixtures where the team will need to show people why they are the highest scoring team in the NFD and also the lowest conceding team. Tricky fixture, coach.
Yes, a crucial fixture. I think it's exactly what you say, and that's the message to the players that, you know, if you want to win a league, you want to be champions, you have to. We've done a great deal of good work throughout the season. We've come through a bit of a difficult patch the last sort of 5-6 matches, but it does not take away the fantastic position that we've put ourselves in. So, you know, we have to look at it as an opportunity. We have an opportunity to go back top of the league by 2 points with 2 games to go, and that would be a very strong a position to be in. So yes, we have to stand up tomorrow. We have to show our mettle. We have to show our championship credentials.
Sure, yeah. Hey, Mr. Becker, we are talking here about a group of players who saw their team going all the way to the PSL and NFD national playoffs just a season ago. A team that fell in the final hurdle last season. Majority of those players are still there. And I know you are not a psychologist, my good sir, but what do you see in your players' body language during this time of the season with 3 games to go, with some even going as far as saying the players are getting tired? Is that the case, or is it a phase which they might get over in tomorrow's game? And how is the support from the management?
Yeah, I know. Look, support firstly from management has been superb throughout. It has always been, and I'm sure it will always continue to be. And, you know, we've got a fantastic management and owners of the club with a great vision for the club going forward. Yeah, no, look, I do think, you know, in the end of the day, people, you know, tend to forget at the beginning of the season, as you said to me, that we would be playing a third last game of the season to go, you know, back to top of the league after being on top of the league for 20 weeks.
Sure.
You know, I would have taken that. I would have been happy with that. And the players, they're fine. You know, they understand where they're at. They understand the opportunity that they have. And they understand that, you know, they want to be playing at the highest level. They want to further their careers, improve their lives. So you know, there's a lot to play for. And hence, you know, the body language is one of a bit of apprehension, but that's not a bad thing. You know, you need to have that feel in the bottom of your stomach and that gut feeling that, that you know, you want to protect that lead that you've had for so long.
Sure.
And now we have to. Now we're the chasers. We were being chased. So, yeah, we will show what our character is as a team, you know, tomorrow.
Yeah, coach. Yeah. And there were also many people who were around during this time last season. They saw the team picking up good points in their last three games of the 2017-2018 season, which in the end meant the team will play in the PSL and National First Division playoffs. And many of those people are still around, coach, hoping that this time around you pick up all the good points again this time. But this time you will gain automatic promotion to the Premier Soccer League. Is this something you've also been discussing with the boys, coach?
Yes, definitely. I mean, you know, it's two seasons back that we went to the playoffs. And in that season, we played away to Thunder Royal Zulu at the time, which is now currently Richards Bay. And they won the league that day by beating us. And the joy on their face and what that achieved, you know, hurt us. And then last season, Highlands Park received the trophy last game of the season against us. And again, you know, to make a guard of honor for the opposition and see them lift the trophy. 2 years in a row, we've seen teams, you know, have that. So it is in our hearts and in our minds. And we hold that to ourselves and say that it is not our time. It is our turn. You know, our time has come. We've seen two teams in the past 2 years lift the trophy. And, you know, we have to make sure that we are the ones this time around. So, you know, as it stands, we need three big performances in the space of 10 days. We play Wednesday, Sunday, Sunday. It boils down to this. We've put ourselves in this position. You know, we deserve and earn the right to be where we are. And now we have to finish the job with three big performances, and we have to rely on just that determination and that desire to be successful.
Yeah, coach. You know, there was also during this time last year, during this stage of the season in the 2017-18 season, winning the last three games of the season would have meant Stellies booked themselves a place in the PSL and NFD playoffs. But now I'm sure you know what it would mean for your team should they pick up all the 3 points in all the remaining fixtures of this season. Have you started talking about this good news around your players? Is it something that you talk about to the boys, or is it a matter of taking it one game at a time, as they always say?
Yeah, look, I think, you know, we've taken it one step further where we don't even take it one game at a time. We take it one day at a time, one training session at a time. You know, what's important is we're a club that wants to be, you know, successful club in South African football for many years to come. So it's embedding a culture of worrying about your next training session, and after that training session, you worry about your next meal, what you're eating, and then you worry about how you recover and how you sleep. And that's all we want to do, is concentrate on the next important event. And then that will allow us to prepare well, and then the match will take care of itself. And then once the match is over again, we then worry about the next training session. And that's been our philosophy throughout the season, and will continue to be so. We've got our processes, we trust our processes, we follow, and you know, it has got us this far, and we don't doubt that we will continue to be successful. We have the league in our control currently. You know, we're the ones that win tomorrow. We're back on top of the league.
Sure.
And that's important for me, that we just stay in control. If it means the last game of the season we have to win the league, you know, I'll take that.
Yeah, my coach. Good luck with that, coach. And now, going into your game versus Tigex Galaxy tomorrow afternoon, as a coach, during this time of the season, do you still need to motivate your players ahead of such tricky games, considering what is at stake? Should they rekindle their form, which put them there in the first place?
Yeah, I think if you need to be motivating players at this time for what is at stake, then you don't have the right group of players. So no motivation is required. They know what they need to do. They understand what needs to be done. And they are highly motivated. So, you know, I'm not too worried about the motivation levels. Mm. It's more about the execution on match day, taking our chances when we get the chances, and making sure that we're nice and solid when we don't have the ball. So motivation-wise, it's high. It's there. It's been there throughout the season. It's now just a matter of just executing when it really matters.
Yeah, coach. They normally say it doesn't matter how the wins come or where the goals will come from. As long as we win, we are good to go. And now the fact that your last three games are here at home, is this something that you think will work as a plus for the team, coach?
I hope so. Playing at home doesn't guarantee you 3 points. But what it does guarantee you is that you are playing in a familiar environment with your own supporters behind you, and that you don't have to be travelling, which can be demanding at this back end of the season. Yeah, it is nice to know that we don't have to leave Cape Town in the next 10 days. And especially with this game having been moved to Wednesday, You know, imagine having to play today and then on the weekend we would have had to maybe travel to Triondo. Would have been tough on us. So, yeah, we're pleased that all three games are here in Cape Town. But, yeah, it's a matter of using it to our advantage. And that's the important part. It doesn't guarantee you win, so we have to go work for it.
Yeah, Coach. Now, Coach, my final question. Coach, without making any detailed comparison, I know times have changed and this team is different from the group of players that you led from the NFD to the PSL with Amatax back in 2012. But are there any things that you think you will need to change or do different in terms of motivation and playing tactics here at Stellies?
No, not necessarily. I think, as I said, you know, we have our philosophy as a club from the first day of pre-season, the way we want to do things. And we stick to that philosophy, both on and off the field. What we are at Stellenbosch, so you know it's important for us that if anybody came to watch the team from anywhere across the world and they came to see us play, we have an identity and we have a character about our team, and I think that's important for us. We need to continue with that, and if we do, it'll put us in a fantastic position to be challenging and having the opportunity to get promoted.
Yeah, my coach. Yeah, a tricky fixture for you tomorrow, coach. But a word of motivation from all of us here at Soccer Laduma. A bottle of champagne is ready for the May 4th at the Stellenbosch. Good luck, coach, against TS Galaxy tomorrow. Hopefully, you will gain that spot, the automatic spot, which you deserve. You worked really hard this season, coach. And good luck in your game tomorrow. And good luck also in your next three games.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Much appreciated.
Yeah, we thank you very much for listening. As usual, keep in touch with Soccer Laduma on the Soccer Laduma website, on the Soccer Laduma social media pages. Look out for our shows as well on the Soccer Laduma website. For now, thank you very much for listening and goodbye.
Soccer Laduma Radio. Soccer Laduma Radio.